Click the bell icon to get latest videos from Ikeda.
Hello friends, in this lecture we'll study the concept of frequency reuse. Frequency reuse is necessary because we have a very strict spectrum bandwidth in which we have to fit multiple users. Before starting to frequency reuse, let us understand the concept of cellular. What is a cellular concept? Initially, in the mobile communication system, a very large area was given a single transmitter base station which had a very high power. And hence, very limited amount of channels could be used in that large area. And also, reusing the frequency in the same area was not possible because of interference. This was solved using a cellular concept. In cellular concept, the design system was designed in such a way that there are multiple cells, every having a base station which is smaller in height and transmitting less radiations. In this way, we were able to reuse the frequency in another location that was geographically very apart. The base station in the adjacent cells were given different channels. The reason was to prevent interference, because the frequency of the nearby cell is adjacent to the frequency of the current cell, then there are high chances of interference, because it might happen that the filters are not filtering the frequencies properly. Hence, how do we define frequency reuse? The design process of allocating frequencies to every cell is called frequency reuse. In this diagram, we can see we have multiple cells which are hexagonal in shape. The very first question that we might have is, why do we have hexagonal cells? It could also have been possible to use circular cells. But using circular cells would create two issues. One, we cannot cover the entire area without overlapping the cells. Or, if we do not overlap the cells, then certain areas might be left out. The second option is to use a square. The third option is to use a triangle, an equilateral triangle. But when we think about an equilateral triangle and a square, the area of these two figures is very much less than the area of a hexagon of the same size. Hence, hexagon is considered to be the most appropriate suited for the design of the mobile communication system. And also, hexagon represents the circular radiation pattern of an omnidirectional antenna. Omnidirectional antenna, we all know, is an antenna that radiates equally in all the directions in a circular fashion. Hence, in this diagram, we can see we have hexagon structures which are placed in a honeycomb fashion. We can see here we have multiple cells which have been named as A, B, C, D, E, F, and G. And these cells are repeated. One set of A, B, C, D, E, F, and G form a cluster. These seven cells, or the flower-like structure that we can see, forms one cluster. And these clusters are repeated multiple number of times. What is the meaning of naming the cells as A, B, and C? Every cell is given a set of frequencies that are available from the entire spectrum. Say I have an A set of frequencies. In the next cell, I will not be using the same set of frequencies. I'll be using some other set of frequencies which are named as B. Similarly, in the next cell, I'll be using a completely different set of frequencies and name it as C. In this fashion, I'll name all the cells having different frequencies from A to G. These seven cells together form a cluster. In this seven cells, I'm using all the frequencies of the spectrum that is available to me. But let us try and understand. Do we have a limited region in which we are going to transmit the information? No. We have a vast area that needs to be covered. A city, a town, a country. but we have very limited spectrum that has already been used in one cluster. So, to add multiple users, we repeat these clusters again and again. The reason of doing this is because the cells are apart from each other, the co-channel interference might not occur. What is the meaning of co-channel interference? Say I use a cell with a frequency set A. I have another cell with frequency set A, but that cell is apart from each other. Because they are geographically apart, the interference might not occur. Ideally, the cells are not hexagonal in nature. If we go on the ground and check, the cell structure is amorphous. It depends upon how a transmitter or a base station is able to communicate with the mobile station. If the transmitter or the base station and the mobile station are satisfactorily communicating with each other, that is the region which is considered as a cell. Hexagon is just used as a geometry for system design purposes. Actually, the cell structure is amorphous in nature or irregular in shape. Let us now see how to calculate the capacity of this entire system. Let us assume we have S number of total channels. These are the channels that are available to us in the entire spectrum. Now what we do is, we divide these S channels into N number of cells. N number of cells together form one cluster. In this N cells, in one cell, we give k number of channels. So, the number of channels that are available to us in one cluster is nothing but k into n. So, your total spectrum is divided into n number of cells and every cell has k number of channels. Now, we are assuming that this is not the only area in which we want to transmit. There's multiple areas that we need to transmit and reuse the frequencies. Hence, these N cells together form one cluster. And by repeating this cluster again and again, we are able to achieve frequency reuse. Assuming that there are M clusters that have been repeated again and again to cover the entire geographical area of town, city, and the entire country. So, the total capacity C is given as M into K into N. The number of capacity increases as the number of clusters increase. In the next slide, we will learn about how to find out a co-channel cell. First, let us understand what is the meaning of co-channel cell. Say I have one cluster which consists of seven cells. In our case, it is a flower-like structure. And we have cells numbered from A to G. Another cluster is nearing this cluster. In that cluster, we have same number of channels given as A to G. I want to find out another G cell that is nearing this cluster. This is known as a co-channel cell, having the same channels that have been used in a different geographical area. First, we need to understand how many number of cells together can form a cluster. It is not so that all the number of cells can be formed into cluster. There are only certain number of cells which can be converted into a cluster, which is given by the equation N is equal to I square plus ij plus j square. This equation is formed because of the hexagon nature of the cell. In our case, if we want to find the co-channel cell, then we need to move I cells ahead and then turn 60 degrees in the anti-clockwise direction and then move J cells ahead. In our case, I is equal to 2 and J is equal to 1. Hence, N, that is the number of cells in a cluster, is equal to 7. Here, to find the co-channel cell, we will move I steps ahead, that is 2 steps ahead in any direction. Remember, because of the hexagon structure of the cell, we have 6 directions in which we can move forward. meaning in the first tier, we have 6 co-channel cells available to us. We move I cells ahead, that is, we will move 2 cells ahead in any direction, and then rotate anti-clockwise 60 degrees and then move again J cells, that is, 1 cell. And the cell that we reach will be nothing but our co-channel cell, meaning it will use the same frequencies as our channel is using. It is very important that the co-channel cells are separated enough. If they are not, there are high chances of interference occurring because they are using the same set of frequencies. Let us now try and understand what is the effect of having a larger cluster size and a smaller cluster size? Meaning, what is the effect of having large number of capital N value and a small number of this N value? If I have a larger cluster size, meaning I have many cells in a cluster, then the co-channel cell is far apart from each other, due to which the interference is reduced. But the number of channels that every cell will get is very less. On the other hand, if I have a smaller cluster size, say I have only 4 cells in the cluster, means every cell will get 1/4 of the total available channels, which is very high. But the other problem is that the co-channel cells are near to each other, because of which there are high chances of co-channel interference. Hence, the value of N should be optimum such that every cell has good amount of channels available and the interference from the co-channel cells is also less. So, the frequency reuse ratio is given by 1 upon N, which is nothing but the number of channels that every cell has. In the next slide, we can see a state of Maharashtra having cellular system in which multiple cells together form one cluster. 7 cells here are used to form one cluster, and this cluster is repeated again and again to provide cellular system coverage to other geographical locations. The number of cells in the cluster needs to be optimum in such a way that we have less chances of co-channel interference, and more number of channels should be available for every cell. Thank you so much for watching this video. Stay tuned to Ikeda and subscribe to Ikeda.